Howie the Voice, your boy, Marks 1205 numbers after the name. A little tight Tuesday action over here, man. A little game plan comes down to the minute, to the wall, to the wire. And maybe some of the lads. I mean, I have a couple of videos, but maybe I won't post them. I don't really know what I'm going to do with them, man. Maybe at some point I'll post them over here. Maybe some of the lads, zombies kind of coming into multiplayer gameplay over here. The horror point, man, which I didn't really get a chance to speak about that much last week. I think last week we hit on infected, and I forget what the other one was. Maybe we did do horror point. I don't know. But it was cool, man. It was a really cool like event. It was kind of strange. I'm still a little bit torn as to, like, because I remember the initial message of this game was to be a serious World War II game, like the equivalent of like Saving Private Ryan was for like movie folks to like know about World War II was gonna be the game, and it started that way, and now it's like, yeah, man, zombies, I'm a little bit torn as to how, I mean, I know how we got there kind of, but like it. I don't really know. So for every time I kind of sit there and I'm like, "Ooh, I really like that," I think to myself, I was like, yeah, it doesn't really fit like the initial vision, but I guess visions are visions, right? You can change them. That's kind of, I guess, how it rolls. And you can adapt, and it's fun. So at the end of the day, it's fun, so I'm gonna let it slide. It ain't like with my vision or something like that. It's all chill, man. But I was kind of shocked with, like, the new, like, we got a new division, like, come in, new basic training. Like, we got a specialist came in. I just unlocked it. I might put up some cavalry footage next week. Hopefully, maybe get some specialist footage, too, for you guys. But I just unlocked it. So, basically, I thought, like, you would just get, like, the all the perks together. But it seems that for the specialist one, you actually have to unlock it. Like, you actually have to prestige your division and get it. So, that kind of took a little bit longer. I literally unlocked last night. I stayed up till, like, hella late. And then just killed it over there. The cavalry division overall, just initial impressions. I want to talk a little more about zombies in this, but the cavalry division overall, I like it. It's a little bit confusing fully what to do with it, but I like it. I wish somehow I could just get rid of the riot shield like that. I'd almost just co-sign. I like the whole thing being amazing. But you gotta wear the riot shield, and it makes sense because or else that division might be a little bit OP. To me, it seems like one of the better divisions definitely to use in objective game modes, specifically in war. Like Operation Neptune, when like those guys are like shooting you on damn with the turrets. You put that shield down, and 90% of the time, they will not be able to hit you unless like you just like having to literally put your back to them. So that's like pretty cool to have that kind of option. On the flip side, as somebody who lays down that serious murder game on Operation Neptune, it kind of sucks now that like I just can't like it, they made it a little bit more difficult for me on that regard. So, you know, quid pro quo. It works both ways. There's nothing really too negative go about that. The cool thing is I used it a couple times in some of the multiplayer matches, like just playing Kill Confirm and stuff. And even then, it like kind of increases. I haven't used it in Dom yet, but even then, it kind of increases like the what you get for tags. Like I think you get 85 for the red ones, and like 75 I think for like the blue ones and stuff like that. So I was able to get like kill streaks a little bit quicker than I anticipated. You're obviously taking a weapon though that like you're kind of taking the base weapon because you're kind of stuck with the shield and you can't plug any attachments. I guess maybe you could put a perk in there or something like that. That could allow you to put attachments to your secondary, but then maybe you have to be forced to use a secondary. I didn't think about that, but maybe that's a little way to wiggle around that. I doubt it. So you know, it's not ideal setup, but it's interesting in some of the stuff that you could do with the cavalry division, and it's interesting to see people using it smart. It's fun. Like I use it a lot in war, and in war it's like entertaining, especially like, so let's say an Operation X2, you manage to crack in there and you manage to bust into B, for example, into the B bunker, and then like I would go and I would shotgun maybe like a guy or two, but it'd be like a third dude, and then I just put myself in the shield at the corner and I wait for my teammate. And the guy, like, 90% of the time doesn't know what to do. And I'll even put, like, Hunker on, for example, and be like, all right, now I'm a real tank. Like, you literally can't do anything with it. So it's interesting. I'll put up some gameplay on it, man, but it's interesting. It's interesting to see them adding. Like, I thought the Resistance would be – I was shocked when the Resistance Division got added. And then I was like, oh, that's definitely it. Like, that's a wrap. And then they just added a whole other division. And I'm like, what? Like, what are we doing here? I don't know. Interesting how this game has kind of developed, and I also thought it was cool how we rolled right into from one event to another event, right? Like, we rolled into the zombie event to the liberation event. Like, I was pretty, like, quick. Like, okay, because normally it'd be, like, a week, two, like, kind of die out, but this was, like, one's done, other one's going. Go ahead, double XP, 4th of July, knock yourselves out. Like, Okay, I see you. I see you, Call of Duty. Like, I see what you're doing over there. Keeping that momentum going. That's pretty cool. The zombie event was pretty cool, though, man. The Horde Point was a really fun mode. Unfortunately, I think I talked about this a little bit last week about keeping modes. This one might be a tough one to keep up. I don't know if we'll see too much in this footage. It might be in here, but like there was times when I was on a flag top. There was times when like frame rates were dropping because of how much issues was going on between like the zombies, the fire, people shooting. And I honestly have never really noticed a Call of Duty game that dropped frames, and let alone drop frames to the point where it's like, whoa, I can really see this thing drop frames. Like, wow, that's very, very noticeable. These games are kind of built to not drop frames. Like, they probably could look a ton better if we risked, like, the drop of frames. But the smoothness of Call of Duty has always been what's kept it on top in terms of the multiplayer genre. So it was interesting to see that. And I can see why maybe keeping that whole, like, kind of a thing open. And also, you know, you kind of look at, like, what, like, some events are about. Like, this is clearly, like, part of the Zombies event. A little bit tough to just keep that random game mode that has nothing. Like, where do you put that in? I guess a special playlist? You just put it like, here's some odd stuff playlist. Like, here's just some random stuff kind of thing that we're just going to throw into together. Because it's not really like you can pair this up and be like, hey, man, here's a Horde Point and here's the Zombies mode. I guess if you had done a little bit more in terms of like unique kind of like playlists or unique game modes, you could maybe just like leave up like, hey man, here's where the game modes that came in, the zombies, the you know, operation, here's the game modes that came in, Operation Liberation, here's the game modes, but there aren't really that many. Maybe you can make just one playlist maybe also with just all of them. It's like, here's the unique game modes that came. Maybe you could do it in that way. You kind of find the way to like pair them up over there, but naturally it doesn't seem to fit anywhere else. Now, the actual playing it was pretty cool, man. I mean, at first, like, I was pretty keen on just killing the zombies. I was like, all right, let me just kill the zombies. And then I went through a phase where I'm like, all right, well, I'm not getting anything except for, like, 10 points for the zombies. I got to kill, like, the other people. Like, that's what I'm really trying to do over here. Make sure that KD working. Make sure we get that dub. And then I just got to a mix where, like, all right, well, I'm just going to kill everything. Like, I'm killing the zombies. I'm killing the people. I'm killing everything. I don't really give a damn about anything. And in this map, I'm using over here the shotgun. This is the, like, zombies, like, prologue map as well. I don't know if they call it prologue. I played it before. Like, I'm not crazy to think this, but I played this before it became the prologue. Like, when I first played this, when the game came out, it was just, like, had a name, and that was it. I don't know anything about this, like, prologue thing. I gotta go do it. There's actually, like, this week, I saw that there was a, like, an order on the multiplayer to go do it. So I was like, okay, I'll do that. That's a nice way to kind of, like, mix and match the two over there. But I like this map. This map was dope, like, for what we're doing. I wouldn't mind this honestly being a multiplayer map, kind of, to keep it in there. Now, I think the multiplayer rotation now is fine. We've finally gotten up to the point of the game where there are enough maps, and they're good. Like, we finally made it to that point. And I'm playing on the Xbox. I don't even have DLC 3 yet. I haven't even seen DLC 3. I know it's Stalingrad and, like, stuff like that, but I watched, like, a little bit of the trailer, and that's it. Actually, I did watch the trailer, but the trailer didn't really give too much away. But I haven't, like, even seen it. I'm really looking forward to it. Because normally when I go now that the maps are on Sony's side, I'll kind of know the map even before I play it. I'll be like, all right, well, this is kind of how this goes. This is how it goes. I'm going into DLC 3 blind. Whenever that comes out, probably, like, in, like, 3 weeks or something like that, I'm going in blind. Which would be entertaining, man. But now we've gotten to the point where there's a good amount of maps, so I would just suggest adding a map for adding a map. But this map worked pretty well, man. And by the way, it worked pretty well with the shotgun. And also, this flamethrower, some serious part of the game. Zombies, they don't like fire. Pro tips right here. Pro stats right here. Man, jumping around. Come on, man. Get that C4 out of here.